In the previous class, we learnt about probability density functions, or PDFs. We looked at various types of PDFs, including binomial distributions, normal distributions, and log normal distributions. And we saw that we could model the probability of a particular outcome, such as the number of tails results in 5 coin flips, as a PDF, relating the range of various possible outcomes to the expected frequency of occurrence. In many real-world problems, we may need to consider multiple factors that can be best represented by a PDF. Imagine I wanted to determine the likelihood of Sydney's main water supply, Warragamba Dam, overflowing and leading to flooding in downstream places like Penrith, Richmond, or Windsor. The likelihood of the dam overflowing at any particular time depends on a number of factors. One factor is how much rain falls in the catchment over some specified period of time. We could also think about how dry the catchment is before the rainfall, which will affect how much runoff is generated to actually flow into Warragamba Dam. But we also need to consider how full the dam is at any particular time, and therefore how much available capacity it has to hold back the floodwaters. All of these factors vary over time, so their state at any particular moment is largely a matter of chance. This chart shows how much water has been in the dam over a 20-year period. It also shows the full operating storage as the green line. We could use this information to produce a PDF for the reservoir volume available to capture inflows at any particular moment in time. We can see that such a PDF would range from 0 megalitres to around 1.5 million megalitres. It might look something like this. Now, let's say we have a 24-hour rainfall event that leads to a certain volume of runoff being generated and flowing into the dam. Well, rainfall over 24 hours is highly variable, so we could represent that by a PDF, which might look something like this. How can I determine the likelihood of too much water flowing into the dam, exceeding the available capacity and the dam spilling? To calculate the overflow volume, if any, I could use the following simple equation. The overflow volume in megalitres equals the inflow volume minus the available storage capacity. But what numbers should I plug into this formula? At any particular time, both the inflow volume and the available storage capacity could be any value on their respective PDFs. If at a particular time runoff is low and available storage capacity is high, the dam won't spill. If storage capacity is low and runoff is high, it will. But what are the chances? With what frequency should I expect spill conditions to occur? To answer these questions, I need to develop a PDF showing the calculated overflow volume. In this case, the two parameters in the equation are also PDFs. I need to subtract the available storage capacity PDF from the inflow volume PDF. Can you do that mathematically? What if the PDFs are completely different shapes? How would you do it? In this class, I'd like you to come up with one example of your own, where a final PDF needs to be derived from two or more input PDFs. What is it that you want to produce a PDF from? And from what type of PDF data could you produce it? Can you give the equation that you would use, like the one that I gave to derive dam overflow volume? Any examples will be acceptable. They don't have to be based on engineering concepts. You can think of an example if you try. As usual, I'll ask a few people to present their examples at the start of the class.